today. I saw a sign for lemonade. They were the cutest kids I'd ever.
I was just on the phone with Mayor Tom Barrett. I want to tell you, I thank him for congratulating me. We made a pledge that we're going to work together because we both care deeply for this state. We love this state, and we're going to work together to make sure Wisconsin works again. Thank you, Mayor Barrett. One of the most exciting things about this race has not only been the grassroots phenomenon we've seen, but how many people have come in out of the woodwork, people who've never helped a campaign before, but people who said there's too much at stake in our state, in our country. They stood up and heard the call and said, we're in the game. We're ready to take our state back. To everyone across the state who voted for me today, I say thank you. I say thank you. You've given us a mandate for true reform, and I appreciate that. I will not let you down. But to all those others who may not have voted for me, let me be clear. I intend to be governor of the entire state of Wisconsin. No matter where you live, no matter what your background, no matter who you voted for, we all live in Wisconsin together, and we're going to move this state forward together. And I'm not going to look to the past. I'm not going to look backwards to lay blame for the difficult challenges we face ahead. I'm going to look forward to the future as we find solutions to the challenges we face to get this state working again. You see, this election wasn't about me. It was about all of us who care about taking our state government back. And we have some significant challenges. You know, I've traveled the state from one end to the other, from Superior to Kenosha, from Sturgeon Bay to Prairie du Chien, from La Crosse to Sheboygan, from Wausau down to Janesville and everywhere in between. And I got to tell you, a lot of times I stop along the way and we talk to folks, and I find from every one of those places and everywhere in between, the same thing is true. People are scared. They're scared about the economy. They're scared about their own job or their spouse's job or their neighbor's job or their kids' jobs. Well, finally here tonight, I get to tell you, come today, you don't have to be afraid anymore because help is on the way. Tonight, I want to tell every worker, every family, and every business, big or small in this state, that you have an ally in the governor's office. Wisconsin is open for business. My first act as your next governor, if we take the oath of office, is literally to go back to the governor's office and declare an economic emergency, and in turn call a special session to bring the legislature in, Democrat and Republican alike, to work on an agenda that creates jobs by helping small businesses ease their tax burden, reduce the regulatory burden, the litigation burden, and repeal the state tax on health savings accounts so more employers can put people to work. Those things we do in the first days will show how serious we are to kickstart our plan to create 250,000 new jobs by the end of our first term. Now, looking ahead, we face two major challenges. And let's be serious about it. They are significant challenges. We've got to get this economy going again, and we've got to balance the next state budget. But you know what? I've said this before, and I'll say it again. Times of great challenges bring great opportunities if we're up to the challenge, and we are up to the challenge here in Wisconsin. Within the next week, we're going to meet with lawmakers, Republican and Democrat alike, as we forge together to chart out a new course to pass a jobs agenda in our first days in office to send a clear message here and across the country that Wisconsin is open for business. You see, tonight we declare that Wisconsin is open for business because now is the time for we the people of Wisconsin, to stand up and reclaim our rightful place in history just like we did a generation ago. It is time for we the people of Wisconsin to stand up and put the government firmly on the side of the people again. It is time for us to send a clear message here across this state and across this great country that Wisconsin's best days are yet to come. God bless you. Thank you, and let's get the job done.